going to talk to you about using the refractive index method, which gemologists use in their labs in order to determine whether or not a gemstone is actually what the gemstone is. And as you know, even though a gemstone appears to be a certain mineral, it is not until we know by testing it. There's over 30,000 minerals out there, and the possibilities for anything blue can be a numerous different types of gemstones. So what I'm going to be showing you is testing it with the refractometer liquid, and that's going to determine whether or not it's actually a genuine sapphire. Now, once we decide if it's a sapphire or if it's glass or what other gemstone, that doesn't discount whether or not it is enhanced. It can come up as a sapphire, but it's not going to tell you unless the gemologist looks deeper into the stone, taking other tests and determining whether or not the stone has been enhanced. So with that said, the reason I'm bringing this up, because many of my clients and people that I speak to are buying the presidium. It's a tool that is available online where people are testing their own gemstones and they're selling them. But as I consult with so many of them, and on my Facebook group page especially, when people test through the presidium and it says it's sapphire, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's genuine. So a lot of times people get excited and they say, Gina, oh my gosh, it's a ruby and it's genuine. And I always just try to divert the excitement. I know it's wonderful to think that, but a lot of times if it's absolutely stunning, I will insist that they get the stone out to the GIA Laboratory in Carlsbad or Los Angeles and have the stone actually lab certified. And that way, a beautiful gemstone can be sold with the pedigree paperwork. So today, we're going to show you this stone and what we would normally think is a sapphire, and we're going to test it. So stay tuned, and I hope you enjoy the video, and I look forward to teaching you a lot more. So do subscribe, and see you in a minute. Okay, so here we have a pair of blue stones in a halo setting. And what we are going to do is we're going to take our refractive index and we're going to put the liquid on the cylinder so that we can apply the stone directly to the liquid. And with that, we will look into the lens, and in there is a line that's going to tell us with a number system of what this stone is actually going to measure. So we're going to close it up, close the top. We're going to try to get our eye. Now we're moving my head up and down because we need to see where the line, the measuring line, is going to fall. So sometimes that is the case. It's not easy. Okay, so here I found it, and I'm feeling pretty comfortable with it. So now I'm going to look at the measurement, and there is going to be a comparison chart that I'm going to be looking at. Now, if this was a sapphire, the sapphire is going to be up in a certain measurement, but there's also a possibility it could be something else. But I'm looking at it and I'm saying, I'm not really sure about that because it doesn't appear to be an obsidian stone. So we're going to look a little further, but I'm using this as an example because we know it's not going to be obsidian. And so we're going to be looking at it and we see that actually it's going to be glass. So these stones that we thought were actually a sapphire, and the measurement therefore then looked like it could be an obsidian, because of the measurement being close to it. As we look closer, we're saying, no, it is glass. So this is a really great method that a gemologist uses, and I hope that helped.